Okay, this part starts with our PNU clock kit, which is based on this hardware. It's in the blister distributed from ST. It's a very simply way how to play PSM motor and our library. It contains a white board, which is a nuclear board with F302 family. Then it's some power stage AHM07 with integrated driver, and the last one it's some green motor, drone motor, and some power adapter. Power adapter, it's not part of the delivery of the first kit. We selected this one because it's easy to play with the bus voltage, and it's useful for our hands-on on the Thursday. That's about all. We will start with some very fast testing of the hardware. We want to use some binary file. Usually we put it to the installation package, but we make some small mistake, and in Thursday it's not implemented here, and on Friday we put it here. I am not sure which version you downloaded. If you haven't inside documentation the binary file, please ask me and I will distribute flash drive with this binary. On this binary it's some testing firmware for this kit. How to use the binary? You have to find it and send to our Nucleo. Our Nucleo board contains some parts. In this top part, which is cut through the some line, it's ST-Link. That's debug tool for the downloading and debugging the code inside the micro. This contains also some USART communication, virtual COM port, and last part it's some virtual driver, like node underscore and the type of the MCU. You have to right click on the binary file, then find send to in your language, could be different, and one of the drive it's not F302. Okay, if you have the binary file, you can right click on the name, use send to, and select the node, and after that you will see that part of ST-Link contains LD1, and this let start flashing. It's mean that indicate that program it's downloading, and our micro it's downloaded through the selected firmware. Then short description about the stuff on the kit. We have there some reset button, important part. If some code is lost somewhere, you can reset it. Then we have blue button. It's a user button. It's possible use it in application. Then we have a potentiometer. Then on the blue board on the top we have a red LED, which is possible also use in our application. On the white board, on the nuclear board, it's a green LED. Then in this case we have two possibility to indication LED. And how it's about the testing firmware. There is some description about button. We will use in this example button for start, stop and acknowledge fault. In some cases our library indicate fault state and we have to acknowledge it. Then we have green LED, and we use this LED for the indication that the motor running. And second LED is used for the two states, fault and fault over. First it's fault now, it's that I don't know, you haven't connected power plug. And for that reason, you will see red LED flashing, because it's actual fault and it's indicate problem. It's now you have to take care about that. You can put it down, and there is space on the bottom. Second information is that fault over. It means that something happened in past. I have unplugged DC source and I connect it. 12 volt is now on the V-bus, but the application have to react on this fault, and you have to confirm that condition is good to start. And that's our second indication. You can acknowledge this fault through the pressing blue button. And last one, it's a potentiometer. Potentiometer is used for speed regulation. Simply regulation with some loop. And that's all about the description. And that there is some chart that we have some way how to control. We can press the start button, the application switch to the run state. If you press the stop, then you will return back to the idle. If you use workbench for the control, then you will go to the run state. And if some fault happen, you unconnect the power plug, or you receive different fault, then you will see the active fault or fault over, and through the fault acknowledge, you can jump there. Okay, we will start with some slide, which is in past name hands-on and hardware tool. I like it because describe what is necessary to do and where it's possible find, and some additional stuff. It goes through the some objective that you have to find some software, some necessary hardware, describe workflow. It's important part. Okay, then we have to find hardware. Today we have a pnucleo kit, but if you want, you can find a different one. Then we can profile through the motor profiler parameter of the motor. Today we will go with different way. Then we can use some workbench and jump to the generate project. Our motor control project to the some IDE. Today we will use Atolic, which is ST solution now. We switch from IR to Atolic because during the trainings we every time have some problem with the licensing, because it's not free of charge. We have some temporary license for the training, but still it's not work at all in all cases. Then it's easy to use our solution, which is free of charge for our usage. And it's work fine. It's not an issue to use them. Then last step, it's about some configuration or testing if it's running well and etc. We can use the motor control workbench with some parts of that, which is monitor part, and we can play with this application. We have there also a knob like standard potentiometer. We have there list of faults which can happen, and there is some action button, start, stop motor, and etc. And that's the goal for today. Test our application, which is coming not from binary but from the workbench, and we will test it. Then some slide about hardware setup. We have there some solution, some power and control board. You can use big evolution board, which contains big or small TFT display for the graphic way. Then you can use motor control connector. Some of boards, big evolution board contains at least one connector, motor control connector. Some of them contains two connectors for the dual motor motor control, and you can connect it to the big power stages. Second possibility is inverter. It's mean that some power part and control part is together on one PCB. This one it's some bigger one, and last one it's some motor control kits, which demonstrate like your case some Nucleo as the control board, power stage, and some motor. And we have also big motor control kit, which contains big motor, big power stage, and etc. That's what you can select. Then reference of boards, which is supported directly from the today release. And you can find it in the release notes of the workbench, and there is some list which control boards it supported. Now it's still changing. We add new boards. Then also evolution board, big boards that's ordered by families. And now we have good luck that we are ported to the HAL AHL library and QPMX, and now we have also support for L4 and F7, and for the future we have open doors. Then some slide about the inverters with different configurations and etc. And last table it's with boards. This first part it's about some old style but from my point of view good power stages, big power stage usually fit on the high voltage, contains also some bridge, you can connect it directly to the mains. Of course be careful that work on the main it's a danger, and then it's some additional parts, and now we have some additional boards which is a new style, and this is not contains conversion from AC to DC. You have to apply DC voltage. From my side it's pity because I cannot demonstrate to customer it at all. We have to have a power source for that, but if you want to play with the motors, then you of course you have to buy some DC source, and you can use it. That's different range from some watts up to some kilowatts. That's a very huge range. Then software setup. We already use some kit. You can download directly installation from our sites, but to be sure that you have all things what is necessary, we go through the installation package way, and for that have in one package also a compiler, motor profiler, workbench, etc. Then how you can find it? One already touched through the Jiří, some repository. It is located inside documentation or user folder, and second one it's inside the program files, and you can find there as the workbench folder and motor profiler. Again, supported IDE link for them, but in the installation package for training it's already Atolic part. Then I will go very fast through this, but it's also important because we will use ST link part of the Nucleo board, and for that we have to have some drivers, and there is some slide with the description if PC have some problem with the installation, how it's solved. Then setup of motor parameters. We have a nice view from the version 5.2. We changed the face of the workbench, and now we have only one graphic picture with possibility to click on the motor and define the parameter, click on the power stage and define a parameter of that. All is in one part. Then we can define or find the parameters about the motor with the profiler. But for today we will, that's some slide about motor profiler. You have to select board and play with that. Now it's time to use Workbench and define motor control project. We can go through the new window, new project, and then select application, control part, motor part, or switch to the inverter, and then at the end select the motor, if it's saved. Or for today, we will use some predefined example. For this pNucleo kit, we have predefined example, which is named pNucleo, but it's not in this, it's scrolled in the opposite side. But you can find pNucleo kit with bulk running motor. And it will be task for now. Then you have part with the parameters of control unit, and also with power stage, all its configurable. Some part you can see online. If you change configuration, for example, from one shunt to three shunt, it will be replaced with one shunt topology. If you cancel, for example, bus voltage, you will see that the link to the micro it's hidden, and it's demonstrated that it's not used. Then we have also some kind of application type. It's predefined some startup procedure, how to handle startup or another condition. Okay, then we have to finalize firmware and generate a file from the workbench. We will click on some button, generate button, and workbench on the background call QPMX and generate IOC file. That's a project file of the QPMX, and also generate some parameters. Through the compilation, you will combine with the setup, additional setup, for example, with TFT display, what you want to have inside application, combine, and through the compiler, compile, download it to the micro through the ST-Link, and last step is tune in real time, check if it works well, and then it's possible finalize the application. Then some slide what is the necessary to put inside the motor parameters. Through the compilation we can again in this way generate. After that we have to select proper IDE and configuration. Now it's supported F4.27. I think you have it because it's we put it to the installation package. We will use TrueStudio, and there is two possibility about the hull driver selection. That's not mean that in this case when we have we selected AHL library abstract layer, it's not used for the real motor control part. It's used only for the initialization, to be sure that it's in the abstract layer, it's possible read it in the fast way. But it's cost some code, extra code, because it's in the abstract layer. You have seen in just before lunch one table and comparison if you use AHL or low layer. After you select TrueStudio low layer, you can click on generate, and you will switch to the some special window which demonstrate which file is generated and etc. At the end you have to open IDE, and there is a way if we cannot associate a project file directly to the TrueStudio, you have to go to TrueStudio, then open workspace in the TrueStudio. It's if you open any project, TrueStudio ask you about the definition of the workspace. After that, TrueStudio save configuration of Windows and etc. What projects are open and etc. That's the location of the workspace. You have to define the proper space, and you can open the proper project. After that, you have to compile. For that, it's dedicated icon or short key with Control B. And after build the project, compile the project, you can download it to the micro. But TruStudio haven't any simple way how to download it. For that, we use jumping to the debug session, which is just on the start, download the firmware to the micro. And for that, you can click on the icon or press F11. And immediately we terminate the debug session and let the application running. And terminate it's possible do by icon like red square or Control F2. And that's it. There is some slide how it's work in Kale or IR. That's quite similar. And last step it's go to or switch back to workbench. Open the monitor part, which is icon with some dashboard, and then connect to the your application. Usually it's only one communication port, but if you have a computer with some virtual or something else, you have to check the proper communication port. Speed it's on the default state 115k, and then you have to connect. Start the communication firmware with the firmware, and then you can use start fault acknowledge, control the speed with the knob, and etc.